I don't want to hear, but it's something about the way that she talks about Jesus. She makes Jesus Christ look beautiful. She says his blood can make me clean. Can I ever be clean? She says his truth will set me free. She says he has the power to give me peace. Father, I need peace. Father, I need to be free.
My freedom came at unexpected costs. I wandered the streets a few nights, wondering if my freedom was even worth it, if I should just go back. But just before the cold became unbearable, a woman on the way to the prison found me. She asked if I was okay, and I told her my story. She offered me a bed at a woman's shelter she owns. The bed was hard, not soft like I used to. The sheets were scratchy and they scraped against my skin. I should be crying, but I'm smiling. I should be angry, but I'm happy. I should want to go back, but I am free. I am no longer downtrodden.
I visit the downtrodden now. Those in need of redemption. I met this lady. She seemed sort of kind. I knew if she had her way, she wouldn't be living the kind of life that she's living. And so I led her to Christ. And I gave her some advice. If I could find my peace, then so could she. May the peace of God that passes all understanding be with her.
I found peace when I visit the woman in uniform. We fight for justice because it is not a sin to fall in love. We fight because love still conquers all. Every day I visit the prison, every day, she gives me hope.
I visit the prisons too. It's a fulfilling thing to take the message of hope to those in chains. In this prison, the murderer of my husband is here. Anita, the woman in uniform. She has this light in her eyes. She's not afraid. She's been sentenced to death and she is pregnant. I hear her story and I feel sorry for her. Her only fault was that she was a woman that fell in love with the wrong man. And now